मैंने कल 4 दिवस पहले वीजा वेरिफिकेशन पास किया।
And when you present Samriddhi, also present the brief of your second assignment and your scribbles and your documentation with whoever is coming next.
So give me the second and third one.
You did not try to resolve that form on top. Don't give up on forms. This is very good, but you did not resolve it yesterday. Okay, instead of me or ma'am critiquing it, I think ma'am, we'll ask the class to critique it.
Yeah, so they start seeing also.
Exactly. So now zoom into your first idea, I mean the first explorations, first sheet, and let the class judge and let the class give you feedback. Presenter, can you zoom into this first sheet of hers?
Oh, ma'am, can somebody else share? My network is very weak, so it won't zoom.
Yeah, I'll share the screen.
Okay, class, you have to give feedback.
Could we start with Ashna since this is for her?
Okay. Ashna, critique your own work.
Where is Ashna? Let's not waste time.
Ashna, the client. Ashna Khanna.
Ma'am, I guess she's not in class.
Give me a moment. If she's not in class, tell her that she's been marked absent.
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
I'm just checking the attendance. It's absent to you. Okay, then others can pitch in.
Others. Kanishka, Manoj. Kanishka, will you give feedback? Where is Kanishka?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, come. Start. Switch on your video, Kanishka.
Yeah, just a second.
And the presenter should also keep the video on.
Yes.
Ma'am, so I think in the first row, in the second middle one, there should be enough space between the form and the word mark, the logotype. Same goes for the first and the second one in the second row. For me, I think the second one in the third row works overall. Yeah, and she could maybe try with some various typefaces also.
Okay.
Like more explanations.
So basically, she needs some more explanations. You're saying with typeface.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Rhythm? Rhythm?
Yes, ma'am.
Switch on your video and give feedback. Rhythm?
Ma'am, I like the...
No, you have to switch on your video. Please switch on your video.
Now we need not tell everybody all the time to switch on the video when they're talking.
Yes, ma'am. So I like the second one in the second row.
Okay. Why?
Because I think how the name is placed beside the logo is quite interesting.
Okay. Any other feedback to her?
Is the font, is the second one in gray or is it black? This, the one that Rhythm pointed out, is it gray or black? It seems... Or is it just a very light font? It's a light font?
Yes, ma'am.
Have you reduced these and done a printout?
Yes, ma'am, I have made printouts.
Rhythm, would you like to add anything more?
Yes, ma'am.
Doesn't work. Can you say what doesn't work or what else works for her?
Ma'am, I think the fonts which are placed below the logo aren't working very well as compared to the ones who are placed inside.
Okay. Why do you feel that?
Maybe because when they are placed like sideways, both are seen properly, like they have the same kind of attention maybe.
Okay, that's a good point.
Ankit Kumar, switch on your video and give feedback, please.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah. I think she could try the third one in the first row, just the other way around. The text should be placed on the right, aligned with the bottom of the monogram.
Are you writing down the feedback, Manushi? Are you?
You could also try a sort of font which may be italics as it goes with her monogram. It could be problem with readability, but maybe she could first try and see.
Okay, that's a good feedback. You should try. Basically, you've just tried with two typefaces, as I see. You should explore more so that you are able to see what is working and what is not working. That's the whole idea. What else, Ankit?
Yes. That's all I see for now, ma'am.
Ma'am, should we give feedback now?
Yes, why don't you start?
Right here. Rights to annotate, please. Somebody. So, in the form itself, Manushi, I see a problem here. See, I'm marking it out. This area. Have you seen the marking? What is happening is that this decorative element of A, it as it forms the crossbar and it transitions into K, that transition gets a break. Okay, if that needs to be, you know, done very, smoothly. Okay, so that transition, you need to ensure that it is a smooth transition. Okay, again, this space here in between, it might disappear. So which means that maybe the K needs to start from somewhere here. Okay, understood? So this I feel is a problem in your form. Now about the arrangement of your the symbol or monogram and the word mark. Now I personally, if you ask me, I quite like these explorations done by you today. Okay. It's a very good effort. Somewhere I feel that there is a kind of visual balance in almost all of them. It's a good effort by you. But as Ankit pointed out, you need to try more with different typefaces. So try, and maybe we don't go ahead with it, just to see how the visual language transform with a different typeface. You need that exploration. If you ask me personally, I really like this one and this one. I'll tell you for a simple reason. Even this one is quite interesting. These two in the middle column, specifically because of the weight of the typeface. The weight of the typeface and the weight of the monogram. Somewhere there is an alignment in that. Visual alignment, right? Even though the point size is very small compared to the monogram, yet it stands strong. But this is too big. You'll have to check the size of it after the printout. If first you take in the same, take the print in the same size, then second, if it doesn't work, then you reduce the size of the reduce the size of the monogram or increase the size of the logo type accordingly. Okay, and then see whether it's working or not. Here in the last one, just a little bit of more distance between the monogram and the logo type, and try it at the bottom also, like this one.
Right? Yes, ma'am.
Overall, I think very good explorations. I really liked your explorations.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, over to you, ma'am.
Yes, I think I absolutely agree with you about what you said about the form. Otherwise, the curves are quite smoothly done. That is also, except for the joint and these two. So, I think you've made a lot of progress. I personally like the ones at the side because they kind of add to the movement of the whole whole flow, you know, as it is, it has a flow and then this adds to the flow, and at the same time when it's in the center of the K, it kind of anchors it in a direction. This one is interesting, but you need
ma'am, could you ma'am, could you please mark it in a different color so that she will explore further? A blue color, maybe a different color, so that she knows.
This one, I'd like you to explore a little bit with size at present. I think, you know, if you could make the size kind of match this height, I think the balance will be even better. So this is the one I'd like you to explore with sizes, with different fonts. And this is interesting, but there's a little bit of a clutter here.
One can't see on it. Okay.
So can you see what distance you can place this at to avoid this kind of clutter here? Otherwise, it's an interesting one. And you look at the space vis-a-vis, can you try and keep at least a minimum distance, which is the width of this stroke. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Or double the width of that stroke, see what is needed.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay? So I think you work on what Kanupriya ma'am has marked and the other, there's just one more I want you to work on and different
points. Yes.
So Arushi, okay, sorry, ma'am.
No, that's
fine. Okay. So Arushi, see, visually and technically, after you take printout, maybe this proportion here, where I'm making a star might work in terms of size of monogram and the size of the word mark. Maybe this proportion will work for you. However, this typeface at the bottom, you'll have to check its visibility. After
ma'am, it is like I have the printouts, yeah. So like I have to change the typeface
because it's weak, no?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
so
ma'am.
The other one will work more because of the weight of the typeface.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, but this proportion, ma'am. If you check the proportion, which proportion is working more, and what is the size in which you've taken the printout, Manushi?
Half inch. One, I had the smaller scale.
No, what is the size? You have to write the size. No, what is the size of the form inside? Is it one dimension should be 3/4 or and 1 inch? So two basically.
Ma'am, it's like a half of A4.
No, that doesn't help you. I have been shouting my lungs out since yesterday. Reduce the size of the overall form on your computer screen. Bring it to half inch, one. As in, this will be, put it in half inch, one dimension. Then put it in 3/4 inch, one dimension. And then put it in 1 inch, one dimension. Take a printout of all three and see which dimension it's working and what you need to change in that.
Okay, yes, ma'am.
Half A4, anything will work.
Okay, yes, ma'am, I'll do that.
So today. Smaller size, you need to take a print and see. It will be like this small thingy on A4 sheet. Just this small, three sizes, one in three-fourth size, one in 1 inch, 1 inch, 1.5 inch, one in half inch. And right below this one is half inch, one dimension. And then take print out.
Yes, ma'am.
Otherwise, you'll never be able to judge.
Yes, ma'am.
Next option, Arushi, Manushi. See, that top form on top was is very interesting, which you did not resolve. The first one that you showed yesterday, you've not resolved it.
Yes, ma'am.
You don't leave things halfway, I feel. Students will give feedback on form, based on characteristic and how she's done this arrangement. So Ankit Sikdar, switch on your audio and video and give her feedback. Ankit Sikdar. Ankit, if it's difficult with your video on, you can switch off the video. Yeah, now Tom. Ankit, you can switch off your video. I think you are having problem with internet.
Yeah. Okay. Nandini ma'am?
Yes, sorry, I got a little lost in between the connection was.
No problem. Do you want more students to give feedback?
Yes, let's have some more students.
Okay. Nikki Patel? Please give feedback. Video on.
I like the one in the
Can you speak a little louder? And there's a little noise in the background. Yes, start please.
Yes, ma'am. I like the middle one in the last row. And also, about the logo, like the monogram, I feel like the A is looking more like I.
More like I?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, what else?
If I'm in the last row, first one, like the first attention is going towards a Khanna instead of Ashna.
Good point, Nikki. Anything else?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Samriddhi Joshi, switch on your video and give feedback.
Ma'am, for the video, I'll have to switch to my phone. So can you give me a second? I'm using my laptop.
Vivek?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, please give feedback.
Yes, ma'am, I'm facing few internet difficulties. So is it fine if I have my video off? I'll use the audio.
Go ahead.
Yes, ma'am. So, ma'am, overall, I really like the way she has created the form, like the combination mark. But the thing is, at times, the typeface is being overpowered by the monogram, and the monogram at times is being overpowered by the typeface, I feel. Like in the extreme middle one, the typeface is being overpowered by the monogram. I like the way it has been arranged in the one below that now. The one below the middle one, like this in the third row, middle one, ma'am. I really like the way it has been arranged.
Third row, middle one, okay. Because the balance is right, the typeface is quite heavy. The monogram is quite heavy. So she's reduced the size, which is kind of creating some balance.
Yes,
good thought.
Visual balance over here. And in the one before that, I feel the main name is being less focused on.
Yeah, absolutely. Agree. Manushi, are you paying attention?
Yes, ma'am, I'm noting.
Some very good points being made here. Zeal, could you now come in? Zeal?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Video on, please.
Ma'am, in the last one, last row, I think the font size is bigger than the logo.
Last one, last row, you're saying font size is too big?
Yes, ma'am. As compared to the logo. And also, I think Ashna Khanna is in caps lock, so it's not working well.
Okay. I think, ma'am, now we can take over. Ma'am, would you like to go ahead with the...
What I feel is that, again, she has done good explorations, but can you give me the right to annotate? I just would like to point out something. One is that whenever when it's too close, like say here, the name with the your monogram, it closes the A and it starts to look like a Q. So you need to keep the flow of this space like open, so that even though it's there, the A is readable. Your symbol stands as A, it gives it also a base and it's also readable. Otherwise, it's kind of falling on the other side, toppling over. So with this, actually, you can give this that. So maybe something here also would be interesting. You can work out the size, because then it gives this form the kind of space it needs. This is, and look, I think upper lower gives a little interest to it. So it's similar to this. I like this size balance. So just, I think you need to work on this space. How much should it be? This gap between this and this. I think you need to try variations over there so that your A gets a kind of stability. At the same time, it doesn't seem to topple over. Or the other alternative is to see if something works on this side. You know, where you keep your movement, at the same time you let this form visually. Okay, that's my comment. Besides, I think you've got a lot of other feedback.
So, Manushi, personally, if you ask me, the form itself needs a lot of work to get resolved. This gap in between A and K, this gap needs to be managed, because if you see, the gap here is more, and as you go inside, this gap here is less. Okay, this is not resolved according to me. And A does create a very incomplete kind of feeling. So what helps it? See, standalone, I feel if you ever at any point of time want to use this form, standalone, without the name of the person, without the word mark, this will standalone not give you the visual balance.
okay, suddenly it looks like it is going to fall on the other side, you know, on the left side, according to how I'm looking at it on the screen. It will fall. It's about to fall, basically.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so that's the kind of feeling it is giving me again and again. And I feel that to get the visual balance, something maybe, you know, was required here. Something was required. Therefore, if you see, your arrangement of word mark is working more like this. As in like this and like this.
Yes, ma'am.
Because what it is doing is that this, I agree with ma'am, that the way she's drawn this, it is giving a support to your monogram.
Yes, ma'am.
So it is also helping the I to complete the A. But standalone, it will not work. So it should work standalone, because in caps and all, it will be embroidered. In t-shirts, you will use it without the word mark at some places. Standalone also, it needs to work. Does it have a visual balance if used without the word mark? This one doesn't. So honestly, as explorations, all this is very nice, and for learning, this is very good. But I think the one above has more potential, and it is closer to resolution. The first one that you did not explore after yesterday's feedback also had potential. But looking at the situation now, the one we discussed earlier has more potential. And the feedback given by students is very good. I think they have begun to see now. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So I personally feel that you explore this just for your understanding, that, okay, how is the placement of the word mark working, the sizes and all the other aspects. How will you balance the visual weight, right? But honestly, the other one is more resolved. After you refine that form, like we discussed, the other one looks more resolved to me.
I think you have to see what you can do here. If you want it to work, maybe just a point, you know, here or something. Yes. Like this.
Yes.
I don't know. You will have to work that out, and how will you find that? And another thing, this space, maybe you could follow the same space here.
Yes, ma'am.
In all the three places. Here, I mean, that should work.
Yes.
But I think, like Kanupriya ma'am said, the earlier one is definitely better resolved. The first one has potential. I think spend more time on the first one so that that can be improved. Isko just give it a little effort, because it's good learning to try and make things that don't seem to work, work. As a learning exercise. Okay.
Manushi, next assignment. Show your brief, show your explorations, and also the presentation based on yesterday's discussion.
I have one kind of exercise that you could all try. Is see, when you've left spaces within the form, try and see how they close, how the eye travels, and allow the eye to travel. Do it as a pencil line or something, and then do your placement of your name mark, the word mark. I think it will help you. Just see the direction in which, in various directions, where does your monogram make the eye travel?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, next.
Ma'am, is my documentation visible?
Yes. Okay, wait, stay here. Stay here. Have you had a basic class in typography and layout?
Yes, ma'am.
What's the point size of your text here in the body text?
Ma'am, it is 15, like according, like it was written in the
template.
Yes, ma'am.
You should not go beyond, see, this is too huge. You should not go beyond maybe I don't know which type. What is the font called?
Helvetica, ma'am.
Helvetica?
Yes, ma'am.
So Helvetica, I think, ma'am, will work. This kind of website, I think they've taken some version of Helvetica, which is too broad. I think in 10 also it might work. So
10, 11 maximum.
Yeah, 10, 10.5.
Depending on the font.
Exactly. And then and this is 8x8. You cannot have. See, one of the basic things that I'm telling you, that when we read, the eye movement is from left to right. And then we go to the second line and then left to right, which means you see we're creating a Z every time we are reading. When your line length is so long, okay, it is difficult for the eyes to trace the second line. Therefore, your column needs to be smaller. In body text, if it is not going to go beyond, say, it's point size 11 or point size 10, okay, which means you will be able to accommodate more letters in the same line, which also means that you will have to decrease the column length. Okay, so maximum which works is 62 or between 64 to 70 letters in one line. You getting my point?
Yes, ma'am.
So which means that your column has to be shorter. This is for everybody. And there are only 34 students present in the class, remaining have left. Please tell your friends to please join immediately, because these things will not be repeated again and again. Have you got the points?
Yes, ma'am.
Your line length cannot exceed, you know, between 64 to 70. If it is 64, better. And this is too huge. Currently we are looking at it on the screen. But however we print these documents, especially when we are printing these documents, we are holding it in our hands and we are keeping these documents closer to our eyes and reading. You don't need such a huge size. Look at the point size in brochures, in newspapers. You hold the newspaper, hold it closer to your eyes and then read. Isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
So breaking it down in columns is important. Okay, next.
The other side is, other point also, can you just take that?
Sorry, ma'am.
First page, can you just go to the first page? Right, this, not the one after that, the body text one, the one where you have text. See, generally on a page, we would put much, we keep more space in the margin, which will go when you do a double page. This, give me, right? This space has to be at more than this space. Definitely. You can't go so close to the edge of the paper. That is also one thing. And what is the space, the leading here that you've chosen? Is it the... Manushi, what is the leading? Or have you just taken the default leading?
The default leading.
Maybe 110 would be little better. When you're just reading text, can you try that also, all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay, that's just that.
And we get rid of the hyphenations.
Yes, ma'am. I
And keep the margin 1 inch from all sides. I think, ma'am, 1 inch would work. What do you think?
Yes, 1 inch will work.
1 inch from all sides, yeah. That would also help you break the... And even if you have like a page, the whole page, but to make the design aesthetic, you could have a column which is like this small.
Right? And then what about this headline, casting a monogram? Just think about it. What would be an appropriate word? Are we casting a monogram? What is the meaning of the word casting? Just think about it.
Yes, okay. And other thing, ma'am, I just realized that while exporting as PDF, I didn't make it in the facing pages. So like the pages are one by.
No, in the InDesign document only, you have to create a document which has facing pages.
Yes, ma'am, I made in facing pages only.
Yeah, but in this also you can make it facing pages.
Yeah,
in your PDF also.
Yeah, I missed out that part. So here it is not the facing pages. So like, ma'am, should
which
I?
Which software are you using for presenting the PDF?
Ma'am, I have uploaded the PDF file, so I'm showing that only.
But कौन सा सॉफ्टवेयर सपोर्ट कर रहा है आपके सिस्टम में पीडीएफ को? Anyway, what I'm trying to say is you can make it PDF here also, facing pages here also. Some softwares are giving you that Adobe Acrobat and all those DC. They give you the option to make it facing pages. Is the point that I'm making.
Okay, ma'am. Once again, I'll export it.
Yeah. Okay, next page. Quickly. Can we move on to the next page? That's it? You don't want to show more of your document, Manushi? Manushi? Has she left the meeting?
Ma'am, maybe she got disconnected.
Okay, I want to now see the second assignment also, because we've discussed the first assignment quite a lot. So second assignment, scribbles on graph paper, some explorations of the with the name of the company, brief of the company. Quickly, who, Sakina, would you do that? Sakina?
Sorry, I wasn't able to hear you.
Sakina, present the second assignment. Your explorations, brief of the company.
Actually, I'm just uploading. My net is very slow. I'm not able to do it. I'm
okay. Divyam, I want you to do the second assignment.
Yes. Assignment is very scribbly. I
still
don't have a perfect idea. So
doesn't matter. Show it.
Okay, ma'am. Mom, is the screen visible?
It's still black. Yeah, now it's visible.
Okay, Mom. So, my client said he wanted a company. So, the concept of the company was to do a gaming on two different platforms, where one platform will be in a remote area, and the game will, the original game will be getting played on the on a remote location, and by using internet you get
it in your can't hear Divyam,
so, hello
Divyam, yeah, your voice is breaking in between.
Hello,
yes, speak, go on.
Ma'am, am I audible?
The company is basically about
doing a cloud gaming, and he actually wanted to make a company such that you have two different systems on separated with a distance, and you get the feed on your own computer. So he wanted to name the company Parallel, as in you are able to play the game via means of net. So these are my ideations, and he actually wanted the whole company to revolve around gaming for Mac users, because there is some software which is available for the PC users. So I thought about it, and I thought he. Maybe we can do something which resembles copying, as in the whole system is being basically copied to your system. The whole game process is basically getting streamed on yours. So there is a connection between two computers. So I thought a Mobix strip would actually represent the whole concept of interlink. Then the whole concept, this whole thing is called cloud gaming. So I also thought about like a cloud which is cut from between, and like that is showing a parallel connection between two things. I also thought about like collecting two clouds together. So on the left hand side, the second one, you can see the two clouds are being connected. Still I'm in the ideation process. I don't have very solid ideas yet.
Okay, but I like your basic thought. At least the core thought is there. I missed a lot of points in between because your voice was breaking a lot, but I the way you are explaining the name of the company, I think is appropriate. You could also suggest some more names. Who's your client?
Vishesh, ma'am, Vishesh.
Okay. So I mean, it's interesting, but you could also think of another name, and you could discuss with your client. And I mean, I quite like the basic thought of, you know, the especially the parallel clouds that you've tried to create here. It's quite interesting. However, sometimes, you know, it's very important that your design is free flowing, but even the free flowing designs have kind of sometimes have a construction, you know. So if you're using a grid, try to use that grid, the suggestions, the measurement suggestions with the grid is offering you, if you try to utilize that. And because it's gaming, you know, so you have tried to use some visuals which are pertaining only to gaming. Okay, like the keyboard and some of the other visual elements. Now, while it is a gaming company, but you know what happens is that supposing tomorrow the keyboard which is being currently used by gamers, it evolves. Maybe it just becomes like as small as, say, the size of your visiting card. Supposing, because the way the technology is moving, you know, it may happen. So 10 years down the line, when we think of a logo, we have to plan of a logo that it should work for 20 years, 30, while there's a lot of rebranding which is happening. But still, the planning of the logo, it has to be done that it has to work for a number of years ahead. What happens is that the way technology is moving, right? So these signs keep changing. When I'm saying signs, as in this kind of keyboard may become dated after a point of time.
Yes, ma'am.
Then what happens to your logo? Then your logo also becomes dated. It looks like a company of yesteryears. right? So the company also has to stay relevant with the changing times. So what you need to do is not be so specific in your sort of visual language, especially the one right in the center is very specific. So what elements could you take? Like, for example, you could just take the buttons. That may be a standard thing.
Yes, ma'am.
Right? Just that the buttons may not be three-dimensional and they become flat in future. And they become like touch screen in future. Right? These things are happening every day. You know, people are working and evolving technology in compact devices. I mean, just look at how we used to use our telephone. First, that dial-up phone, and then now the mobile phones, which are touchscreen, and which are becoming smaller and slimmer by the day. Right? So these things, your logos need to be relevant. So therefore, your approach towards logo, first in the second row, is something that I appreciate. The thought is very evolved, I feel.
Okay.
So even the first one in the first row, the thought is very evolved. I don't know. I mean, that how it connects to your core idea of gaming, that is something that you'll have to explain at some point of time, the way you explain the clouds. But the abstraction in thought is what. In some of the companies, you can't be very literal, because also there's the concept of brand extension. You look at what happened to Dunkin' Donuts. When they called it Dunkin' Donuts, it worked at some point of time. But eventually what happened? They had to do away with the word donuts, because the company evolved, the brand extended. They extended into opening cafes, they extended into offering more beverages, snacks. So they could not go on with the name Dunkin' Donuts. They had to come back. They had to curtail the word donut and become Dunkin'. Right? So some of these things you have to think ahead. What will the company be 20 years down the line? What if the brand extends? Will the name be still relevant? Will the visual be still relevant? Okay. And yes, this is something that we are basically for. This is for everybody. That's why we are doing a common class today, so that everybody gets. We don't, because if we give it separately to every single person, it will take a lot of time. Okay. These are some of my views. Ma'am, over to you.
I think Kanupriya ma'am has made some very significant points, which I think all of you need to keep in mind. And if you study some of the most successful logos, some of them that have had the longest life, they are a lot more abstract. They create an emotion through the graphics rather than being very literal. Because something very literal, as ma'am pointed out, will, you know, have a very limited kind of meaning. So I do think that these two have potential. Another thing that I want you to try is the word parallel. If you could work on a word mark also. Parallel has those double parallel lines, right? Can you make them a little more playful? Not literally parallel, but maybe it could be just a word mark with no kind of symbol with it, you know? No,
yes, ma'am.
Graphic form with it. That is also something that you could try. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
More explorations required.
Sure,
okay.
Sure.
More explorations required here. I think if everybody is paying attention, though, I can see we started with 42. As a number of participants, which has reduced to 33 at the moment. Now, those who are leaving the meeting would not be able to, you know, gain. They are at a loss, because some of these things we will not be repeating again. Now, if some students are not being able to get it, and I'm disappointed, really disappointed. I have put so many messages in the group to join, for everybody to join, but they're not doing it, and it's disappointing.
I think that you need some honesty from your end. For us, it is a lot of effort to try and teach something online as against a physical class. And then would you have left after just giving your attendance in a physical class? So unless you are honest and you keep your integrity, you won't learn. Should we take one more person?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
I'll call out the name because they don't come out. Who's this?
Samriddhi Srivastav.
Okay, Samriddhi, I like your volunteering.
Is it visible?
Yes, right now it's visible.
So the company's name is Lippi, and they create original typefaces as well as they adapt already existing different foreign scripts into vernacular ones. So the work
into vernacular ones, meaning?
Yes, ma'am. If there is some Latin typeface, they will translate or convert it into Indian script.
Okay.
So they work for clients who want to recreate the same typefaces into a different language without losing its essence. So the brief says that the logo can be abstract, but it should depict the key point, that is adaptation of things or forming something or association of things.
So in the brief, it can't be so specific that it is adaptation, this, that, and the other. I understand where Lippi is coming from. I think what she's trying to say is that supposing there is a logo of a company, ESPN, and if ESPN is present in is advertising, say, in Gujarat in the newspaper, then the logo should appear in the Gujarati script.
Yes, ma'am.
If it is being advertised in the newspaper in Punjab, then it should appear in the Gurmukhi.
Yes, ma'am.
I understand the idea, but
ma'am, so actually the logo can be abstract as it does not have to be translated into a script. It can be abstract, it can be a symbol. But the work they do is that they convert the existing typefaces into that script, wherever it...
Yeah, understood. Absolutely, I understood the brief. But somewhere, if Lippi is saying that it has to have that kind of visual language, you as a designer need to understand the company, need to do some visual referencing of similar companies, like go and see what Indian Type Foundry is doing, or Ictype or White Crow. They load down these names. These are similar companies. So White Crow, Ictype, Indian Type Foundry, then Aksharai karke ek organization hai, Mumbai based, in which a lot of calligraphers and type designers based in Mumbai, they are associated with this organization. So go and check them out, okay. And see what kind of work they are doing, right? Because sometimes you as a designer also has to give feedback to your client that, look, don't be so restrictive in your visual approach. That's the point that I'm making. Maybe what she's saying is appropriate, and you're able to crack it and without, creating too many tight boundaries.
Okay.
Right?
Yes, ma'am.
So yeah, now over to your explorations.
So for now, my approach was to make something related to the roots or linguistics or language to show association or connection in some places.
Well, I didn't understand. What roots?
Like the brief says that we all know how connected we are to our language, especially as in India, a country consisting of 20,000 languages, which linked the citizens to their roots.
Okay.
It includes Hindi, Punjabi, Marathi, Urdu, and Gujarati as well.
Okay.
So in that terms, she's talking about the roots.
So the thing is, like, for example, if Lippy is there, then you need to check with her and if she's paying attention. One thing is that roots, so basically if it is a novel in English,
yes, ma'am.
I still didn't understand. I mean, is it specific to brand names that she's talking? Lippy, are you there?
Yes, ma'am. So, like, at bottom,
specific to brand names, no? Specific to brand names.
Specific to brand names, yes.
So, the thing is that somebody is going to be paying you for this, right? The company is going to be paying you for this. The idea is very nice, but the brief says that getting the people connected to their roots at some level. At some level, yeah, I agree. But at the same time, where the brands are concerned, they need to have a connection with their audience, right?
I have written that to expand their audiences, to connect with them with the language they understand and associate. At bottom, I have written what our target audience and what the companies look in us.
Okay, so that's the core that the companies want, that people should have an affinity with that brand. If they will have more affinity with the brand if they read it in their own script, it brings them closer to that brand, and it makes communication easier. And also as a branding exercise, if you create, say, the logo of Coca-Cola in the same language, visual language, and write it in Devanagari or in Gujarati script or in Gurmukhi or in Bengali, then it builds a closer connection and it brings a consistency in visual language of the brand. That's the core idea.
Yes, ma'am.
So now you, Samriddhi, you tell us how have you interpreted that visually?
I thought of taking elements that exist in every typeface, like the commas, they are the same. I mean...
So how is sameness kind of resonating with the core idea?
I was really confused with the brief and I tried to talk to her, but... she suggested me that I can go abstract about it if I'm not able to really crack it, and then I can build on that to read somewhere, but I'm still confused and that's why I wanted to present right now.
No, we're going abstract just because you don't understand the brief is very funny. You can't be doing that. You have to first understand the brief. Going abstract is a strategy. It's a deliberate strategy. It's not like because you can't crack it, so you go abstract.
Yes, ma'am.
So first you understand the brief. Now the brief is clear to you after we discussed, me and Lippy. Is it clearer? So, Nandini ma'am, do you want to comment on this?
Yeah, I think even I was a little confused. I thought it was a typeface design form.
Yeah,
which kind of did, but this is a very specific kind of service. In a way, just to make it simpler, it's a visual translation service, you know.
Yes, ma'am.
It's like you translate from one language to other words, same way you're translating it visually here. Now, the idea here is to make it more, to improve the connection, right, between their target group and whatever their logo, to make the relationship stronger. So maybe you could look at these abstract ideas. Why is this service offered? what is it that the client is looking for? Better connect with their consumers. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
So those are ideas you could explore, better connect. And since I think you could explore, I think this has got potential, your comma marks, you know, to
yes, ma'am.
Bring in the idea of connect. So maybe you can look at that.
Hmm? Okay.
Or even this, the whole idea. Can you run this?
Yeah, the one in the center is quite interesting, you know, the connection.
Because connection is the kind of, whenever anybody has, gives you a brief, try to write it in one word or two words maximum, as many ways that you can, you know, finally what is the client trying to, wants to achieve.
Yes, ma'am.
So that will make it a little easier for you. When it's a kind of service, some it's easy when they're selling a product, but maybe sometimes a service is a little more difficult. So this is interesting. Yeah, I think the same to that Kanupriya ma'am and Ma, I think both are easy, are interesting and have potential for connect. But can you look at more alternatives?
Yes, ma'am, I can.
Now that you have a better grasp of the brief?
Yes, ma'am, I can.
So there are three that I have marked here, one on first three pages. The last one, I thought it's not making reading easy, but I like the idea wherein what she's trying to do is she's taken L-I-P-I, but all of it is in Roman. Maybe if it is an abstract mark which has been created using, say, the L of Roman and some other script for I and some other script for P and some other script for Y and taking just portions of it and creating an abstraction.
Yes, ma'am.
Understand?
Yes,
maybe
ma'am.
The letters, some part of the letter has been taken just to get abstract, but the letters may not be readable at all.
Yes, ma'am, I understood.
Understood.
Yeah.
So that will also, you know, help you get to the core of the company. So you're creating abstraction, but what you're doing is maybe you've taken one letter from, one script and the other letter from the other script, and all four letters belong to the other. But these letters to get to the abstraction are not exactly recognizable.
Yes, ma'am.
So you, but at the same time, aesthetic and yes, creating ma'am. Some kind of visual language. This can become very interesting.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
So,
one suggestion to add to this, just this, so that it's connected. Maybe you take like parts of some Indian letter form also, because it is making the global vernacular,
yes,
making
ma'am.
The global local. So just don't use only the English fonts, because it is basically from one going towards the other, right? To some Indian language. So maybe fonts that are reminiscent also of Indian languages may be interesting also.
Okay.
So So just a couple of things that I've added here, like the comma idea. Then just the circle idea here, because somewhere, you know, there is something transitioning, from the circles are growing and something is transitioning, some connect is there. Then I mark two on the third page, just a moment. And the last one we've already discussed. So you need to explore some of these further using the graph now. So the graph should guide you to construct some of these forms.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes,
so the thicknesses, the size, everything.
Okay.
Yeah. Next bit of exploration should also be in graph paper. But when you're doing it in graph paper, at least divide the space well now. And then do one in a specific space so that one idea doesn't interact with the other.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next.
Should I stop sharing?
Yeah, next one more person, ma'am, we can discuss.
Okay,
Rishabh, start sharing your screen. Rishabh, somebody send a message to Rishabh, please. Tell him to join the meeting and tell him to start sharing his screen. So clearly some of you are not present behind this wall, digital wall. Yeah.
Mom, can I share?
No, I want to know where Rishabh is. He needs to communicate. People are disappearing from the meeting with their icon there so that they get the attendance. This is not right. Okay, go ahead, present.
Okay. Ma'am, can you see the screen?
Yeah. No, not now.
Ma'am, just a second. Now?
Yes.
Ma'am, so my brief was that it's like a library, but it is like a vintage library which has a lot of vintage books. And along with that, the client also mentioned that there's like a small cafe where you get coffee and other beverages.
Coffee or just coffee?
No, not just coffee, like beverages and like also like some dry snacks and things like that. And she mentioned that it will be very minimal, like the products will be less, but they'll be of high quality. I've tried like taking a lot of motifs that you find in the vintage books and then like some of the abstract, in like in the first board, I've tried some abstract form using just the lines, like a book of style, and then the coffee few feet that we have. And then tried out some vintage forms for me. So like basically the brand name is something that I've not finalized yet. I've called it Books and Brew. And my client. Yes.
Okay. See, the word that you've chosen, brew, is generally used for beer.
Right.
So, I mean, I don't know. In my head, when you're saying brew, it's just beer is getting stuck in my mind. You know? I don't know. I mean, what do you think, ma'am?
So you also say brewing tea and coffee. So I think she could keep it.
Okay.
You generally say I'm brewing tea and coffee, but just maybe we can look it up also. Let me just see.
Yeah, I mean, now I agree.
I checked, but it's mostly for beer. But then I also checked that it's for tea and coffee as well.
Okay, fine. If that works, I mean, I'm glad that you checked. It's just that sometimes, you know, the associations become so strong in your mind. While I agree that it is being used for tea and coffee and some other drinks also, you grew something over a period of time. So, but somehow that association in my mind specifically is more towards beer. But it's okay if the generalized meaning is that you could use it for other beverages also, then I think we can stick to it. And it's also, you know, an interesting name with B resonating twice. So B and B, you know, those kind of things are possible. So it's very interesting as a name. So I don't want you to change it if you've done your research. And also, I mean, sometimes, you know, it's a very personal thing. It just gets stuck in my, it's gotten stuck in my mind and I associate it strongly with beer. But I agree that it is commonly used for other beverages also. So you may, I mean, you may stick to the name. That's not an issue. So when you're saying vintage, then what kind of vintage? Is it associated with a specific region, specific country?
So, no, ma'am. She just mentioned in the brief that it'll be vintage books. So I asked if there's any specific genre for that, but she said nothing specific, like all genres. And nothing like some specific to some area or any other thing.
Okay. These are hot beverages only that she will be serving, or any kind of?
No, she said all kinds of beverages and caffeine.
Okay, I like the idea of a top view, because then you don't get specific to like a coffee mug or a teacup. So that idea is interesting. So the beverages, how the, you can look at how the beverages are served. They are also served in glasses, which may not have a handle. So even this is fine. So for it, you can explore that part also. That 1 second, just a moment. Huh?
Yes, ma'am.
Sini ma'am, could you go first? My surroundings are so noisy that I'm not being able to talk also at the moment.
I will. See, now some of the things you need to look at is whether one option you have is to give it a vintage look, which you have tried here somewhere. You know, look at modern vintage kind of symbols like Starbucks and things like that for you to also get an idea of the possible direction. You could even, I don't know, do away with this handle detail if you want. Look at, just take a few top view photographs of this tea, coffee, hot drinks and see. Another thing you could,
Sachi, mute yourself, please.
Carry that hammer with you.
Vivian, mute yourself.
Yeah, all these are maybe too kind of literal. So don't look more at such ideas, because they're very literal and very illustrative.
Okay.
They may not get you very far. Because if things change, as Kanupriya ma'am said earlier, then it would be too specific. Something like that makes more sense, even this. And try and use like this, also this, you know, symbolic aspects of like the form. Another thing you can try is the texture of the, you know, letter forms maybe. On a book page. Just that.
I did not understand that. Like,
see, texture. Like when you look at, do a book, vintage book close up large, a certain kind of type is used in vintage books, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Also look up some vintage book covers to give you a feel of how vintage books looked like. If you're trying to get the vintage, communicate the vintage aspect, So also find out from your client or think for yourself what is more important, to give it a vintage feel or to give it a modern feel, because here you have to make a choice as to what look you're trying for and then start ideating also.
Ma'am, so she has mentioned that she does want it to look like vintage because that is like the USP, that it's going to be completely vintage, like even the books and even the decor inside. So that is something she mentioned.
Okay. So what I really like is that the brief is very crisp and clear. Vintage books and beverages and some snacks. So basically it's a cafe. It's a cafe and it is a place where you can go and you can read some vintage books. Can you also issue? It's a library?
Yes, it's a library and it has a cafe.
So books and rooms. So a very interesting name also has been given to you. So what you could look at is some woodblock type. Right? Pehle jo Bible print hota tha, ठीक है earlier times what kind of typeface was used, right? Wood block type कैसा दिखता था? So you can do some exploration on that, right? Definitely it's very easy to find some vintage typefaces. You can try this approach, B ampersand and another B. Okay, so B ampersand and another B. This B and B, and then you write books and brew. This approach might work very well. So do some explorations doing B and B, because it's, the name itself is very interesting, I must say. It's easy to remember. It's not difficult to pronounce. It's common words coming together very well, right? Like I said, that I also like your approach of going for some vintage motifs. It's so noisy in my background, I can't tell you. Just give me, continue sharing, just give me a moment, I think. So I quite like the idea of this top view because then it doesn't restrict you to a cup, mug. It's just like a nice interesting movement of say, and with these two lines that it suggests something is happening, you know, something is happening. It may be the top view is a simplified view that it is moving towards abstraction, but it is the top view of say a mug or a cup or a coffee mug, a glass. So that approach is interesting. I wanted to explore this further, and you could use some of these vintage motifs, but see where the inspiration is coming from. You know, where this inspiration is coming from, this vintage inspiration. You should know where you're taking this inspiration. Where does the form, like if it's like a very Persian motif, then why are you taking a Persian motif? If it's like a very colonial motif, then why such a colonial motif? If it is something which has originated from, say, the walls of Rajasthani architecture, you know, anything can be vintage.
Yes, ma'am. Right. And so these I took from like the book covers that I could find on vintage books.
So like you have to. Yeah, then you should also look at some Indian books, you know, like Aine Akbari and things like that. Right. So the manuscripts, the visual manuscripts, or the manuscripts in the Mughal times, that can also be vintage, no?
Yes, ma'am.
If it is something which is based in India, then why take something which is coming from... though I would say that we have very strong colonial influences in our country, so you could go for that. And even Persian influences, you could go for that. But you should know what you are taking and why you are taking. You should be able to justify.
Yes, ma'am.
Right? Portuguese influences, especially in Goa. Or maybe some French influences in places like Pondicherry.
we do have multiple influences, but you should know what you're taking, where that form comes from, and why you're taking that form. Ma'am, do you want to add something?
No, I think also look at a lot of the, even I think there are Indian vintage emblems also. Look at how they've brought it together. Also, besides books, besides influences, elements, I think this is a very exciting project. I mean, to even just, you keep it so abstract and then give just that slight feel of vintage in it. Just a hint of vintage to, you know, a form like that. Where somewhere okay. It becomes, you know, at maybe one of the corners or something, that may be also very interesting. But look at, like Kanupriya ma'am said, specific influences, so you will get very clear and it won't be too generalized.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, should I stop sharing?
Yes.
Thank you, ma'am.
So, ma'am, should we now look at specific work if people want to discuss?
Yeah, if they, I think now we can look at specific if somebody has need some stage of exploration, then they come forward.
So, should we go then group-wise?
Yes.
Today, is it possible for us to break for lunch at, or we can continue with the common session till 12 o'clock? Is it possible that we take a break from 12 to 1?
Yes, absolutely.
And then 1 o'clock we resume, and we resume with the entire class for a common briefing. And then we will look at the first four groups. And then the second round, we look at the next five groups. There are total 9 groups.
Okay, fine.
Absolutely. Everybody is paying attention, no, to the discussion?
Yes, ma'am.
So with that logic, we can look at one more work with the class. Who's watching?
Have they seen Anthony Lopez's work?
They have. Yeah.
Okay. Because there's some very interesting approach to identity.
Yes, absolutely. And especially his identity and the process of Bihar Museum. I can send them a link. Bihar Museum. The process is very interesting, how he arrived at that.
Yeah, it is. Even I think something that he did for that housing is very interesting. And then what absolutely. He did for that conference.
All yes, yes.
Very, very. Yes, I think okay. They should look at that because then they're expanding the boundaries of identity design. Yeah. I think there was one more in his work which was also very interesting. Okay. Is anybody coming up or should we break for lunch? What is it?
So we can just take one person quickly. Or we can break for lunch, I think. It's 12 o'clock, almost 12 o'clock. So we'll reconvene at 1 and everybody will join the class.
Okay.
So, Sachi? Sachi Shah?
Yes, ma'am.
Just write a message in the group that we are meeting at 1 o'clock and everybody should join the meeting together.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. I'm ending the meeting now, ma'am.
Fine.
Ma'am, you take a print screen?
Yeah, I did.
Should I end the meeting?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
on the surface, but you cut through like a knife. And if it was an open shut case, I never would have known from the look on your face. Lost in your current like a priceless wine. The more that you say, the less I know. Wherever you stray, life was a willow and it bent right to your wind. Head on the pillow, I could feel you sneaking in. As if you were a mythical thing, like you were a trophy or a champion ring. There was one prize I'd cheat to win. The more that you say, the less I know. Wherever you stray, signal and I'll meet you after dark. Show me the places where the others gave you scars. Now this is an open shut case. I guess I should have known from the look on your face. Every bit and switch was a work of art. The more that you say, the less I know. Wherever you stray, I follow. I'm begging for you. I put the record on, wait till I hear all. I'm like the water when your ship rolled in that night. Rough on the surface, but you cut through like a knife. And if it was an open shut case, I never would have known from the look on your face. Lost in your current like a priceless wine. The more that you say, the less I know. Wherever you stray, my man, life was a willow and it bent right to your wind. Head on the pillow, I could feel you sneaking in. As if you were a mythical thing, like you were a trophy or a champion ring. If there was one prize I'd cheat to win. The more that you say, the less I know. Wherever you stray, signal and I'll meet you after dark. Show me the places where the others gave you scars. Now this is an open shut case. I guess I should have known from the look on your face. Every bait and switch was a work of art. The more that you say, the less I know. Wherever you stray, my man.
We used to. dress you wearing tonight. If you're giving it to you just right, the way I did before.
I overdosed, should've known your love was a game. Now I can't get you out of my brain.
Oh, it's such a shame that we don't talk anymore.